The aim of the conducted research was to uncover current trends in the vulnerability of the Sluch River flows in the context of potential depletion of its water resources due to climate change and anthropogenic activity in its catchment area. Extensive anthropogenic transformation of landscapes within river basins due to agricultural production in watersheds, excessive involvement of river waters in economic circulation, air pollution and irreversible losses, and the high level of river flow regulation thanks to hydrotechnical construction and hydromelioration. All this significantly disturbed the natural balance of most river ecosystems. Change the hydrological regime of rivers and led to the depletion of water resources in many regions of Ukraine. All these phenomena also take place in the basin of the Sluch River, one of the important rivers for the economy of three regions, the flow of which is completely formed within the borders of Ukraine. This makes it possible to analyze modern trends in changes in its flow regardless of cross-border anthropogenic influences. In addition to the existing small power facilities, the investors have plans to build four more stations in the future. However, as practice shows, hydraulic engineering construction is a significant anthropogenic factor that negatively impacts the condition of rivers and the environment, regardless of the parameters of hydraulic structure, the type, design, purpose, location, etc. The fact that this impact can be significant is reflected in the Water Code of Ukraine and the European Union Water Framework Directive, State Building Standards and the Law of Ukraine on Environmental Impact Assessment. Hydraulic engineering construction affects the hydrological, hydrobiological, hydrochemical and the hydromorphological characteristics of rivers, as well as their ecosystems and the ecosystems of adjacent riverine territories. The negative impact is not limited to the construction period of hydraulic structures and the sections of rivers where the structures and artificial reservoirs are located, nor is it confined to the territories immediately adjacent to them. The negative consequences of certain impacts, such as siltation of water bodies, bank erosion, flooding and waterlogging of lands and settlements due to seepage from ponds and reservoirs, are mostly recognized and regarded as side effects that can be minimized. To address these issues, it's usually recommended to implement compensatory measures, such as bank stabilization, drainage, interception or removal of sediments, selective water intake during releases to lower reaches, and etc. And let's show photos that illustrate hydromorphological change. As we can see, the vegetation has established itself on channel mesoforms, which indicates the restructuring of sediment transport under new flow conditions. In this slide, a geo-informational hydrological model of the Sluch River watershed is presented, highlighting the catchment areas that contribute to the discharge at the three operational hydrological stations along the river: Gromada in the upper part of the river basin, Zvehel in its middle course, and the Sarny in the lower course of the river, not far from its confluence with the Gorynia River. To establish the contemporary trends in the variability of the Sluch River water discharge, existing time series data for annual maximum and minimum water runoff during both warm and cold periods were investigated over the interval from 1989 to 2014.
The total duration of the hydrological observation period was 27 years, and it provided a sufficiently lengthy data set for relevant trend analysis. General trends of the change of water runoff were assessed based on exponential trends. That we did for uniform comparison across different hydrological stations and different flow periods. The results of trend modeling analysis revealed the following. Overall, for studied period, the Sluch River shows a small change in annual and maximum flows. Generally, we may say that there are almost zero trends for annual and maximum flows for the Sluch River during observed years at the stations Zvehel and Sarny. Significant differences in trends for different flow periods through the year were observed between the Hromada station, Dubuque market with deep blue color, and the other two stations, Zvehel and Sarny, over the observed period. In contrast to Zvehel and Sarny, the Hromada station during this time interval shows clear tendencies to decrease in both annual flows and maximum flows. At the same time, and despite the practical absence of one period trends at the Hromada station, there is a noticeable trend of increasing of cold period minimum flows. This increase of minimum water runoff, especially for cold period at the Hromada station, represents the only such case among the analyzed series. At the same time, for the Zvehel station, marked with green color, located downstream from Hromada, pronounced decreasing tendencies for minimum flows during both warm and cold periods. The least change of flow characteristics are observed at the Sarny station. Here is we have negative trends only for warm period of minimum flows. That distribution of water runoff probably caused by different land uses structure. For Hromada, we may see that a huge amount of the areas are on agricultural lands, and there is a small percent of forest and other wooded areas in comparison in other catchment areas for Zvehel and for Sarny. Also, essential influence on water runoff tendencies makes water bodies which located in upper stream of Sluch River. We make some estimations, and the reduction in the flow of Sluch River near Zvehel in summer due to evaporation from water bodies located upstream can be about 2 cubic meters per second. And as a conclusion, we can say that the prolonged operation of hydraulic structures, the negative impacts can intensify, particularly through the spread to other sections of the river and adjacent riparian areas downstream, extending for tens of kilometers or more. The effect of these impacts are particularly impossible to minimize with traditional compensatory measures. They concern change in water flow and channel alterations, which in the case of Sluch River have led to scenes of irreversible degradation of the river system.
Thank you very much for your attention.